Hello everybody and welcome back to another Blender Made Easy tutorial. Today I'll be showing you how to create a seamless looping fire simulation using Blender. Creating looping animation using fire or any other type of physics is a little bit tricky. The reason for this is because simulations work linearly. So every frame is calculated and you can't really go back. Unlike other looping animations where you can just set the values to loop over and over again, simulations don't really work like that. So what we're going to do is use a little trick in the video sequence editor to make it look seamless. To get started, we need to create a fire simulation, so I'm going to go ahead and delete the default cube and then press Shift A and go over to UV Sphere. This is going to be our emitter object, and then I'm going to go over to Object, down to Quick Effects, and then Quick Smoke. This automatically adds a domain for us with the material already in place. From there, we can just scale it up and move it how we want. Jumping over to the physics tab, we can mess with the settings in the fire simulation. Let's first go ahead and select the UV sphere. The flow type, of course, is going to be fire, and then the surface, which is the diameter of the fire, we're going to set this to a value of 1, so it's closer to the UV sphere. Next, to make this simulation look a lot better, we're going to be adding in a texture. The texture will enable us to select parts of our UV sphere where we want fire and parts where we don't want fire. So go over to the texture tab and give it a new texture with the type set to clouds. The size of this is a little bit too big, so let's go with a value of 0.1. Underneath the colors, let's set the contrast all the way up to a value of 5, and then we'll go back over to the simulation and select that texture. Now here is where we're going to do a little bit of animating. So at frame 1, we're going to hit I while hovering over the offset, and this will add in a keyframe. So what we're going to do is animate the texture so it moves around in the simulation. What I want is for this simulation to be about 150 frames long, so I'm going to set this to a value of 150, right about there, and then I'll go all the way to the end by hitting the skip, set this value to about 0.7, and then add in another keyframe. Another thing that we need to do is set the animation curve to linear. So if we open up the graph editor by splitting this view, coming over here and clicking on Graph Editor, you will see this is our animation. It's using a curve to smooth it out. This does not look good, so we need to press T and click on Linear. And you can see there, it's a straight line. Going over to the domain settings, here is where we can set the resolution, divisions, and whatnot. The resolution divisions, I'm going to go up to 64, and then I'm going to turn on Adaptive Domain so it bakes a little bit faster, and then turn on High Resolution. Let's go ahead and play our simulation to see what this looks like. And you don't want the flames to be higher than the domain. You want it to be around that height. And that looks pretty good. You can see it stopping right about there. So what we're going to do now is open up the high res, set it to a value of 2. Then underneath the cache settings, we can bake in our simulation. So currently it's grayed out. And the reason for this is because we need to save our file. So go ahead and press Ctrl S to save your Blender file. Once you have saved your file, you can see that it's not grayed out anymore. So let's go ahead and set the end frame to 150 and then enter. Now we can bake in our simulation. All right, the baking is now done, and now we can start creating the seamless loop. For starters, we need to find the frames where it looks pretty good. For example, this start frame, this does not look good. It's not going to create it seamlessly. We need to find where it looks seamless. So right about at frame 50 or so, it starts to look good right here. And then we can see here, it goes all the way to the end, looking just fine. So at frame 50 and then all the way to 150, we're going to render out these frames, but not the frames before. So set this start frame to a value of 50. And now we can position the camera and render this out. First off, I'm going to select the lamp and delete it. And then I'll go into front view and hit Control Alt 0 to snap the camera to place. Select it and then press G middle mouse button to drag it backwards. Place it somewhere around here. From there, we can go over to the world settings and set this all the way to black. And then for the domain settings, we can select it and open up this panel. Switch it over to the material view by hitting Shift F3 and then press N. And here we can see our principled volume shader just like that. The black body intensity controls the strength of the flames. So let's press Z and go into rendered view. Currently, we can't see anything. So let's go ahead and change this all the way up to a value of 5. And there we can see it in our scene. Now I am going to be using cycles for this render. You can use eevee if you want to. I just found cycles looks a little bit better. The density of the smoke I'm also going to change. I'm going to go with a value of 2. So it just looks a little bit less dense. From there, we can go ahead and save our project and render this out. So for the render settings, I'm going to go with a value of 50 samples. And then in the compositing tab, I'm going to add in the denoiser so it smooths out the render. So press Shift A, go over to filter and then denoise and place that right here between the render layer and the composite. Now, since we're only rendering fire, we don't need the normal or albedo node, so we'll just leave it at the default settings. Jumping back over to the layout, let's go ahead and go over to the output section. Now, this is important. You need to render this in frames. So make sure you're on PNG and then select a folder of where you want your images to go to. So select the output and then navigate to a folder. Now that we've done that, we can go up to render and click on render animation. Or if you have an RTX graphics card, you can go over to system, set it over to optics, which will render just a little bit faster. And then you can go over to render and then render animation. Once this is done, we will sequence it out. The render is now done, and if we want to view our animation, we can go ahead and exit out of that window, go over to render and click on view animation. And this will pop up. And there you can see there's a small cut, so let's go ahead and fix that. To get started, we need to go over to the video editing tab. If it's not here, you can go over to the plus sign, click on video editing, and then video editing right there. And it'll take you to this page. Go ahead and make sure your cursor is at frame one, and then go over to add, down to image sequence, and then navigate to where those images are. Now what we're gonna do is select half of these images, so go over to frame 50, then scroll down till you get to frame 100, holding shift, I'm gonna select that, and it will select every single one of those, and then go add image strip. And we can see it right there. Then go to the end right here, go over to add, down to image sequence, and then import the rest of those images. So I'm gonna go to frame 101, and then all the way down to frame 150, and then holding shift, select it, add image strip. Now we're going to reverse these. So I'm gonna hit G to move it over on this side, and then select this one, G to move it, and move it over here. So what it's gonna do is there's gonna be a cut in the middle, but the ends are going to be seamless. So if we play this, we can see it's seamless right there, but once it reaches the middle, we can see a small cut. To fix this, we're gonna go ahead and move this down a little bit, and then select this top strip and press G and then move it over about that much or so, probably around 10 or so frames, just like that. And now we're going to animate the opacity for this strip. So at frame 89 with the beginning of the strip, I'm gonna set the opacity down to a value of 0. And then I'm gonna hit I. Going to the end of this strip right here, I'm gonna set the opacity all the way back up to 1 and then hit I one more time. And now if we play this, you'll notice there's a very small transition and it's not even noticeable. We also need to adjust the end frame so it matches up. So just drag the end frame back until it reaches that end frame right there. Now if we play our simulation, we can see that it's very, very smooth and there's barely any noticeable transition between those. If your transition doesn't look that good, you can just play around with this strip right here, dragging it further into this other one. So for example, if I drag it further in, and then we go over to the beginning of this animation that has the keyframe, we'll go to where it is this keyframe, I'll undo that keyframe there, I'll go to the end and set this all the way back up to 1 and add in another keyframe. So the transition is a little bit longer. Now if we play our simulation, it should look a little bit better. And there you can see that it's not even noticeable anymore now that it's a longer transition. We also need to set the end frame again, so I'll just drag this way until it reaches the end. We'll restart this and play it, and there we can see it's barely noticeable. And now this will loop seamlessly. So there you go, that is how you create a seamless loop animation. Now what you would do is go over to the output, set it over to a movie file of your choice. I'll just go MPEG and set the container to MP4. The output quality, I'm gonna go with high, and then go up to render and then render animation. And it will grab that sequence editor and then sequence all of those frames into a movie file. So there you go guys, that is how you create a seamless fire simulation. Thank you for watching. If you enjoyed this video, make sure you leave a like and comment down below what you would like to see next. If you aren't currently subscribed, consider clicking that subscribe button to help me create further Blender tutorials in the future. Thanks again for watching.